boom 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 boom. Hey, yo, what's up? Yeah, dog. Shit.
Oh no.
Shit.
Oh no.
Yo, dude, it's Bobby in the house with Georgetown, Gil, and my girl, Khaly. What's up?
No, seriously, though, welcome to another episode of TigerBelly. I'm only talking like that because I was in a music video this week, so,
you know,
Flo Rida, you know, that's no big deal, you know. I've just been in music videos, you know, the urban people like me, and I'm connected to it, the streets. Yo, what's up, man? I was in an Eminem video once.
Holy crap, you are in a lot of rapper videos.
Yeah, and Korean K-pop one time.
Oh.
Yeah. This is a very special week because somebody, tonight at midnight, they have a birthday. And she's an angel. She's my sweetheart. And I love her so much. Khalyla. Khalyla's birthday is tomorrow.
Good job, Khalyla.
November 1st.
Good job.
And if you're a TigerBelly fan and you haven't sent a gift to my girl, well, you got another thing coming. All right? And I want to start off today with a fun fact. Is that okay?
Mm-hmm.
Just something that you probably don't know, but a couple hundred years ago, there was a general in Korea named General Song Pak.
Mm-hmm.
And he had... Why are you laughing?
What's that? Song Pak is a good
name.
Yeah,
Song Pak. Well, it's his name, so... You know,
it's a good name.
Yeah, it's a good name. So this general had a wife and a child, and they lived in Incheon, Korea.
Incheon.
Yeah, Incheon. How do you spell it?
Incheon. Yeah,
Incheon. And his wife and his daughter they had a rare disease. They didn't know what it was. A couple hundred years ago, they were dying. And he was supposed to be in Incheon, but it was the king's birthday, well, the emperor, Emperor Pak.
Mm-hmm.
And this general chose to be at the birthday party for the emperor and wasn't next to his
dying wife and daughter.
Do you know why? Respect and honor. So tomorrow when we have Khalyla's birthday dinner, I expect everyone to be there.
I will be there later.
No, on time.
But later. Because I made a promise to someone to take him to the airport
on my birthday.
On your birthday.
I just found out about
it's
your dinner.
It's disrespect.
Am I not your ate?
Are you gonna be there
you
tomorrow?
Are my ate. Oh, he's not even.
Yes.
No, you're gonna be there tomorrow. Be real.
Yeah, I was supposed to host my open mic for the first time.
Fuck your open mic, George.
You know what? That's what I'm talking about.
But I'm gonna be there.
And I'm gonna just say this right. I made up that whole story, as you know.
So none of that, that's not a real emperor?
That's not a real emperor.
Wait, you just said yes to all that?
Yeah. I just made all that up, right? Just so that to get you, all right? If what time is your birthday, babe?
7:30.
If you guys aren't there at 7:30 at Chosun, I mean, there's going to be a very big problem. Because I've made some sacrifices myself with you guys. I have. And you know what I've done? And I've talked to so many people about it. I've talked to Joey Diaz about it, other people with podcasts. And I go, yeah, when we make money, I'm going to split it four ways. And they go, why? You're the name. You should be 70% you. The rest of them get the... I didn't do that. I did it four ways. Do you know why? Because I'm respectful, love, and honor. That's what I'm about. And if you're not going to be reciprocal, how do you say it?
I think that's right.
Reciprocate. If you're not going to reciprocate that, we're going to have a very big problem. So I expect you guys to be there at Khalyla's birthday at 7:30. So how about a round of applause for Khalyla's birthday? I also want to shout out to... why do you keep looking at her when I yell at you?
What, her?
Yeah.
I looked at her because she looked at me.
I know. But you always look at her like, save me or help me.
I was not a help me. She clearly told you I wasn't going to be there.
Yeah. She did click tell you, tell me, and I was very upset by it.
I'm sorry, guys.
Yeah, you're going to be there.
I will. I told her I'll be there after.
No, on time. Why?
Because I have to drive a friend from out of town.
Okay, how about this? What about this?
If you asked me, can you drive me at 7:30 to the airport, and you told me a week ago, and I said yes, I can't just dip out of that.
What if I send your friend an Uber deluxe?
I haven't even seen my friend. I've seen like 2 days.
Oh.
Because I've been, I feel bad. So I'm going to drive her. That's my gift to her.
Mm.
Yeah.
I'm just
okay. I'm just gonna say this. Mm-hmm. You're still gonna be on the podcast.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
I don't know why you're laughing.
Because you made it sound like you're gonna do something to me, like
no,
it hurt me.
No, but that is a little negative thing.
In all fairness, Gilbert is nice to me all year.
And he's not nice to me. He takes good care of me. Not nice to me.
I'm so nice to you. I respect you. Mm-mm. I call you captain. You call me shitmate. And you know what? I've accepted it because I am. I am a shitmate.
Okay, let's let it go. I'll let it go. Also, what I want to say is a shout out to my new buddy.
Who?
I'll tell you.
Uh-oh.
My new buddy, Danny Garcia. Danny Garcia is a Mexican kid living, I think, outside of Chicago, maybe around Chicago. He told me that he was a little chunky Mexican guy. And him and his cousin and his English friend took me to Osiris this weekend. Now, I didn't go to the lighthouse, but I got pretty close. I got some new gear, and I really appreciate your help. And any of you guys on that are fans of mine, please help me.
So you haven't made it to the lighthouse
I have not,
yet.
Still not made it to the lighthouse.
How hard is this? Like, what's the? Can you compare it to something? Because I don't even know.
Yeah, it's difficult. You have to go flawless. It's basically you're fighting five rounds per game, and you have to win nine games in a row, and you can't lose one. And if you get, it's called flawless. And if you do that, then you get to go to the lighthouse. And not a lot of people get to go, but when you go, great things happen.
So tell us more about your experience with these brand new friends of yours.
The English guy says the N-word a lot.
Call him out. And, call him out.
Hard R or soft A?
Soft A.
Really hard R, soft N.
Oh, jeez. Yeah, he goes hard at the top, hard at the end.
Yeah. But no, it's very soft. The R is very pronounced.
He's from England?
He's from England, and he says the word faggot a lot.
Mm.
And I get really uncomfortable, but also he's very good. So I let it go. Like, I want to correct him. Like, I don't think you should say that, but I don't want him to go, I'm not going to.
Take it to the lighthouse
then. So then I go, say whatever you want to say. And I giggle, just as long as he can do what he does, you know?
I felt conflicted enough to tell me about it. And you're like, I don't think that I can play with these guys anymore. Because
no, the Mexican guy I like. And his cousin, it's just the English guy. He's fine, he's nice, but he just says things, and that's all. You know, and a lot of times it's like you don't have to, like, you know, Democrats or Republicans, they don't have to get along, but they could, you know, there's a space where they can meet, and that's what I'm meeting him in space.
Mm.
Yeah. And why are you smiling?
Sandy Danto has this really good joke that makes perfect sense to me, where he says it's wrong to say the word faggot, obviously, because it's offensive to a lot of people. But they just, the structurally, the word itself is so catchy and so fun to say.
Yeah.
It is just such a great structured word.
Yeah.
There's a hard T at the end.
Mm-hmm.
It's fun. It just rolls off your tongue.
Well, so does the N-word.
Not really.
It's fun.
Van word's not as fun to say.
I hate saying it because I think we're all equal. But it's what, there's two G's in the middle too, like faggot.
Yeah, but it's an R at the end.
They both have it.
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah.
What are other words with two G's?
I don't know.
Yeah,
I can't think of the top of my head, but those are two very good words that you can't say.
My mom's pet pig, Jigga.
Jigga.
Jigga. That's her pet pig.
I also want to say that we reached a milestone on our podcast. We reached how much?
Half a million downloads
in a month,
mm-hmm.
which is
amazing
for us. We're a little over a year in, and the fans and the people have been amazing, and I really want to thank you because things haven't been going well in my career life is great. No, my private life's perfect. My career life, and you guys were
in the Flo Rida video that you're so
proud
about.
What's up, dog? Uh-oh. All day in the hood.
Are you proud of your work in the Flo Rida video?
Well, I want to say this is that because Chris D'Elia is obviously the star of it.
Mm-hmm.
And I saw a rough cut of it. I saw half of it. Whatever. I just feel weird because I'm dancing, and you know, and I know what I look at my face and I go, I know what I was thinking at the time.
Mm-hmm.
Like, what the fuck are you doing? You know, this is ridiculous. But, you know, it cut together pretty good, and pretty much everyone likes it except for one person. And the one person happens to be my girlfriend. She doesn't like it. She thought it was cheesy, right? Yeah, you did.
That's not what I said. Look
at me right now, then. Look at me right now.
Don't put words in my mouth.
How did you feel about the video? And be real.
Nothing against all the talents that are in the video, or nothing against anybody at all. Individually, you, Fahim, Dalia, probably the funniest people I have ever met in my life. But as a video, it was cringeworthy for me. AJ McLean, a Backstreet Boy, was randomly dancing.
Yeah, AJ McLean is a nice guy.
I know. I'm sure. I'm not speaking to anybody's character. All
and
I'm
let
saying
me say
is
this
I,
about AJ McLean.
I was uncomfortable watching it.
When I saw him on the video shoot, I go, "Hey, what's up? Are you a comic?" He goes, "No, I used to be in a boy band." I go, "What's it called?" He goes, "Backstreet," right?
Backstreet Boys. Yeah.
Backstreet Boys. I go, "Oh yeah, that's good," or whatever.
That's good.
Yeah, I don't know anything about it.
Yeah.
I don't know anything about it. I've heard of the Backstreet Boys, but I don't know who's in it.
Yeah.
So that was yeah. And then, but he was so nice. You know, it's like if I'm at a club and people don't know who I am, you know, comedy club, I get a little offended a little bit. Like, do you do comedy? Yeah. You know, I want to go, yeah, I'm a regular here or whatever. But he was very like, you know, cool about it. And, you know, I don't know anything about him, so I have no opinion one way or the other.
I'm not saying
to me he's
not
cool.
I'm sure everyone is fantastic.
Yeah.
Everyone involved was great. That's not my point. My point was you asked me my honest opinion about it, and
okay,
it's not a
so
video
Chris
I would watch
and
again.
Fahim, if you're listening to right now, my girlfriend doesn't like our talent.
I love both of them. That's not true. I love both of you guys. I love both of you guys so much.
Yeah.
Did
you see the video?
I saw a clip.
Yeah. Do you not like it?
No, it's comedy. There's a bunch of girls and there's three comics. Chris dancing like a weirdo. That's the whole point, right?
Yeah.
It's funny.
Chris dancing made me laugh.
Uh-huh.
I will say that.
But you didn't laugh at Bobby's face, but he's kind of just like, like, how do you...
I won't say anymore.
No, I want you to say it.
Review.
How do I grow?
As a dancer.
I want to grow as a dancer.
I don't have doubt in your dancing skill.
Yeah.
You are a phenom. Dance floor.
Thank you.
It's just the I just found it to be a little like
cheesy.
Yeah, like unoriginal. Like you guys collectively are one of our comedy gold, and I just thought that it was like wasted on a video with just dancing and girls, like any other hip hop video. Collectively, you should. I don't know. Whatever. I'm done. Don't make me the bad person here. I'm proud of you for being in a Flo-Rida video.
Thank you. That's all you can have to say. That's all you have to say.
Don't ask for my opinion ever again.
I also was trending last week.
Ooh. I know
trended it. Why?
Is it for the hot ones?
Yes. Yeah.
That was fucking funny.
Hilarious.
Sir.
You saw it?
Captain, that was funny.
You saw it?
Yes. Did you really shit your pants?
Yeah.
Wow.
Do you ever doubt that he shits his pants?
I do it all the time.
He does it every day.
That shit looks so hot, the last one.
Yeah, and I was really angry during that shoot, and I was in a lot of pain. But in retrospect, I saw little clips of it. Mm-hmm. I enjoyed it, I guess. Mm-hmm. And so thank you for watching it, whoever's listening.
That was a really I liked.
That was funny.
Thank you so much.
Hilarious.
And other than that, I've been in a little depression, I think, because of my excessive Destiny playing.
I thought it makes you happy.
Yeah.
It does make me happy when I'm there, but I get irritated. Like if I'm in the car, you know, I just kind of miss. I think I'm addicted to it.
Yeah, and not only is he addicted to it, but now he plays every night with my best friend Gardo.
He's into
so
it.
I've lost two people in my life.
It's not like he died. He didn't die.
Yeah, I'm right
Gardo
here.
Doesn't,
I'm right here.
Gardo doesn't text or call me anymore.
Yeah.
He just texts and calls Bobby.
The Lighthouse.
Well, he'll never go to the Lighthouse. But Gardo is getting better. And he's been playing a lot. Like every time I'm in space, he's in space. And we meet and we have a good time. And do I feel guilty about it? Yeah. But do I care? No. I don't care. I want him to be out there.
In space.
Yeah. And if you're also checking out, if you're in any city, go check out my brother's band, Mongchi Hammer.
Oh, that's right.
They're on tour.
Yeah. Mongchihammer.com, I think, is their website.
So, my, babe, you're 32 now?
I'm 32. Yeah. Yeah.
Wow, I'm glad you said that.
Why?
Because a lot of women, a lot of ladies, they lie. They go, oh, no, I don't want to say my age.
Why would I lie about my age?
32. How do you feel as a 32-year-old?
I threw my back out yesterday.
Yeah, what happened with that?
There was a poster in my sister's. My sister has a gym in her garage, and she had a poster of a Jean-Claude Van Damme doing a herky in Bloodsport, doing like the air splits, mm-hmm. you know, like in Bloodsport. And I thought that I could do a herky, and so I threw my back out doing a herky.
I love Bloodsport.
I was training for the Kumite.
Yeah, I remember. She came home and she was like, her back hurt.
He had to help me out the car, like, everything. Yeah. I was like, I need to help out the car. I couldn't. I threw it out so badly. I can't bend forward.
She can't.
Yeah.
And I remember, do you remember Gymkhana too?
Who's that?
There was another movie called Gymkhana, Bloodsport, back in the
80s. With Van Damme?
No, I think Gymkhana was some with the other white dude. But I really liked those 80s kung fu movies.
Did you watch Kickboxer?
Yes. Good. Yeah, I like Kickboxer. American Ninja.
Next Halloween. So tonight is Halloween. Yeah. Next Halloween, you have to promise me that you'll dress as Jean-Claude Van Damme in that dancing scene in Kickboxer.
Oh. People aren't going to know. If they put a blonde wig on and I'm doing that, maybe they think I'm like Gustafsson or something.
Oh my God, is that Alexander Gustafsson? Holy shit.
Oh, no, it's Bobby Lee. You're going to be wearing that that tank top, like that's a bodysuit, and then some wide leg pants. And you just have to do the moves, yeah. You know?
I want Bobby to go as Alexander Gustafsson. That's
better. Yeah. And I also have, I'm trying to break my addiction. Destiny, I don't know, but I'm going to have to go to meetings. But my addiction toward stalking people on Instagram also has to stop. Mm-hmm. I'm obsessed.
Mm. Yeah.
I get obsessed with people, and I got to stop it. Uh-huh. I have a lot of problems right now, man. I'm in my mid-40s. I might be having a midlife crisis. I'm kind of lost, you know, in, like, obsessions.
Are you going to buy a motorcycle and a Ferrari?
Did you have a motorcycle?
No, that's my motorcycle. Yeah,
we got rid of that. Well, she sold it. They sold it, right?
And gave it
away. Gave it away. You gave it away.
Borrowed. It's borrowed right now.
It's borrowed.
Yeah.
So,
it's Harley.
You guys don't know. How old are you, George, again?
37 now?
Oh, so I'm pretty much the oldest here. Mm. By a long way, I think. Uh-huh. Right? You're 37, so I'm 8 years older than you. I think my face looks pretty young.
You look young. Amazing. I am in just absolute envy of how young you look. It's so unfair.
Yeah. But inside my body is Pat Morita, like broken down.
About to die.
I'm about to die in it. Yeah. And another thing is that I think about my parents a lot lately. Like, I think I lay in bed and I think, is my dad going to die? Like, I think that because it can happen at any moment. And when you get into this age, it's inevitably going to happen sooner than later. Uh-huh. And you think about it and you obsess about it.
Can I give you, like, words of wisdom? Coming from somebody who thought about her dad dying for 4 straight years. Hmm. Thinking about it and obsessing about it every day didn't make it any less or more painful when he finally did pass. So for 3 or 4 years, my dad was basically like bedridden, incapable of moving around, like very, very sick, right? And every day I thought, am I going to come back from school and I'm going to find him dead on the bed? You know, every day I just thought I would get that phone call. So I was always like tense. But, you know, the day that he finally passed, I thought to myself that having 3 years of that would make it less painful for me. I'm like, okay, I already know he's going to pass inevitably. So maybe when he does pass, I'll accept it much quicker. And I didn't. It was just as painful. Whether you're prepared or in fear of someone's death, it is just as painful. I'm just saying that there's no point in obsessing about it every day or having it worry you. Or thinking that you might prepare yourself for it, because it's the final outcome is just going to hurt no matter what. So just accept that at the end of it, it's just going to hurt a lot. And that's okay that it hurts a lot.
But then you question, you also question then, like, where do we go? Is there a God? And all those like things.
What do you believe in?
I don't know. I don't know what.
Did you say AA is Christian based?
No,
it's not.
No.
Okay.
I mean, there's elements stolen from maybe. There's a book called Sermon on the Mount in the Bible and whatever. But there's a lot of things taken out of the Quran and other things also.
But you have to believe in a God, right? In AA.
Well, no, you believe in a higher power, but it's not even that. It's just that what, you know, do you have consciousness? I mean, are you aware that you're dead? Is there something, or are you just like absorbed into this gigantic energy ball?
Maybe.
Or is it something that we don't even know what it is, like an endless sea of black nothingness, and you're like a tennis ball floating in it. And you're just, you're like, I'm a tennis ball. I'm floating in this black nothingness. And then like once every 3,000 years, another tennis ball will float next to you and you can't say hello. Mm-hmm. Oh. You just float next to each other and then you kind of drift apart. And that is a nightmare.
I want, before I die, for there to be a technology to download all my information from my brain, my character, my experiences, my fears, my loves. And then to be able to put that into something in the future, whether it's
like a robot. AI.
Yeah, but I want it to be downloadable, you know?
Well, the hands and the feet will be rusty because of the water coming out of their hands.
I mean, that's why I do envy people who are religious. Like my aunt has cancer right now and she's in so much peace and she's just like, look, like she's just so much faith in a process that I don't believe in. So in a sense, like I am very, very envious of people who have a God that they turn to for everything. They have this radical acceptance of everything that may happen because it's his plan. And there is a huge safety in that. And I envy that because I don't have that.
It's a gigantic safety. Mm-hmm. It's, you know, if you're an atheist and you believe in nothingness, then I believe that you live every moment to its fullest. But it's like inevitably, how do you not think of the afterlife? I'm sorry, this is not a, this is supposed to be a comedy podcast.
No.
But, you know, it's because if it's Khalyla's birthday and I want to talk about real things right now. It's just that what, I mean, I don't, so I'm caught in between because I'm in 12-step groups and I believe there is a higher power and whatnot, but I don't know exactly what it is. And just that question of what is it consumes me sometimes, you know? And like, where does my dad go? Because he doesn't believe in anything, you know? So it's just a frightening thought. And so, and you're young, Gilbert. Mm-hmm. How old are you, 27?
27, yeah.
God, I mean, I had no thoughts of death at 27.
That's not true. I was obsessing about death when I was 16.
Yeah, but when you get to 45... You're right. I mean, I would think about it every once in a while, but when you're 45 and you get closer to the end, I think it intensifies.
Oh, I'm sure. I can only imagine.
Yeah.
I wonder if there's a study out there that shows like a side-by-side of like a link between anxiety and lack of faith. I think that people who don't subscribe to a religion, I guarantee you are generally more anxious than the people who believe in something. Because there's so much uncertainty in what I feel every day because I don't subscribe to any of that. I don't think that there's a God that dictates how my life is gonna pan out. And it does make me anxious.
But can I say, I know, but it's funny because I do know a solution.
What's the solution?
It works every time. And I haven't been doing it.
Double suicide.
No. And I'm going to say something really cheesy, but for me, it's a truth. If I just get out of myself and not think about myself and help other people, you just start thinking about those kind of things.
That's true.
You know, so that's why AA or 12-step groups are so helpful because it's a part of the steps. You know, they realize that, you know, alcoholism and drug addiction is such a selfish disease that, you know, helping others and getting out of yourself, like, you know, going up to a newcomer and going, hey, do you want a coffee? Tell me about, how you feel and what's going on with you. Do you need a ride home? You know, things of that nature. You tend to not think about yourself. And I think that just going giving is the solution. And right now, I'm not giving anything. I'm taking shit from space.
And for destiny. Me, I'm sucking my soul.
I'm not sucking your soul.
Just kidding.
Am I sucking your soul?
No, in healthy amounts of sucking.
What kind of answer was that?
No.
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 But generally, I've always been depressed right around my birthday because in the Philippines, November 1st and 2nd is called Kalag-Kalag.
Uh-huh.
And it's...
Kalag-Kalag.
That's what it's called. It's Kalag-Kalag. It's All Saints Day and All Souls Day.
Yeah.
And all it's a national holiday. School is out. You know, all the offices are shut down. Everyone goes to the cemetery.
Yeah.
And everyone just gets hammered around the tombstones of their loved ones.
Yeah.
It's like it's a city party, but in a cemetery.
If you translate the Filipino language into English, would we say steak?
Yeah.
Let's go eat a steak.
Yep. That's exactly how it works.
With mom,
yeah.
Yeah.
Drive the car.
Why do you think I call you Papaps?
You call me Papaps.
Everything's in doubles.
In doubles.
Yeah.
Is it because if you say it once, you won't fully comprehend it?
Yeah.
What was that? What was that?
Yeah.
Jing jing.
Yeah,
that's like common, you know?
Mm-hmm. But we're all going to die, guys.
True.
But I hope that when I die, that everyone celebrates my birthday on my tombstone getting hammered. Like kalag-kalag. That wouldn't be so bad.
If you died, I'm telling you right now, if you died, like let's say you died tomorrow.
Oof, okay.
Let's just put that scenario out
don't
there.
Don't put that shit out in the world.
Well, let's not, hypothetically.
Okay.
I wouldn't know what to do. Like, number one, it would be so devastating that I would wouldn't be able to move really for months. And then I would definitely probably in the state that I'm in right now, I would definitely go, I'd have to use drugs because there was no way to mask that pain. And then I wouldn't know what to do with my cats and my dog. So I would either call your sister and go, can you take, Gobi? And then tell my brother, can the cat stay with you? And I would probably just sell everything, go to Bakersfield and do drugs in a hotel room.
Bakersfield.
Okay, I have a really serious question for you. Very serious. So you have to take me seriously.
Okay.
If there is an afterlife and if I happen to be some spirit in space, being able to look down on you, mm-hmm. do you want me to haunt you or not? Or to show signs that I'm there? Ooh. Like write on a foggy mirror.
No, don't write on the foggy. Don't do that. Don't do that.
Hi, Pop.
Yeah, Pop. Don't do that. Don't do that.
So no, you don't want me to haunt you at all.
I want, what's that movie with Ghost? Do the penny thing.
That's just as freaky.
No, the penny's fine.
What about her possessing someone else? Like she possessed George and George talked to you.
And I fucked George in the butthole. If you possess George, I'd fuck George in the butthole.
Khalyla, do you like
oh,
that?
Oh, yeah. Because she was Whoopi, right?
She's Whoopi. So she'd be, yeah.
So George is Whoopi.
I would think that his pink dick was a clit and I would rub his clit like this.
George just saying pop.
Yeah, no. And then 2 days later he goes, no, I wasn't really possessed. I just, he just wanted me to fuck him.
Pranked you. Gotcha, Bobby.
Gotcha. Yeah.
No possessions.
No, it would be nice that you would do it, but not at night.
During the day. Yeah.
During the day.
What about randomly? What's always been our song? The Johnny and Mary song.
Yeah.
But which version? Brian Ferry?
No. The Robert Palmer.
So I'll play that song for us.
Where?
Randomly, in your car, all of a sudden.
Because it is one of those songs that you don't hear on the radio ever. So
you would know it's her.
Yeah, but if it's if I'm listening to a playlist, it's in my playlist.
Yeah.
And it's the ninth song, I'm not going to go, oh my God, Khalyla did that. No, it's in my playlist. It would have to be in a situation where I'm at the a doctor's office.
Yeah.
Or the dentist's office. Mm-hmm. I'm in the, and then it played.
Okay.
And then I would have to have the lady behind the counter or the secretary, what do you call them?
It's like receptionist.
Receptionist. Mm-hmm. Go, what is this? I don't have this in my, playlist. And then I'll know, oh, Khalyla did that.
Yeah.
And then
I put on Robert Palmer.
Yeah.
Yeah.
No, do the pop-pops in the window.
God,
yeah? Mirror, yeah.
So
I want that.
Hi, pop-pops.
Yeah.
Yeah.
But I don't want to see, your ghoulish face and your eyes rolled back going, hey.
Yeah. Why
I don't want that.
Would you want Bobby?
Can I write you a letter?
Ooh.
Yeah, where?
I don't know.
Shows up.
There has to be a way for us to communicate. We have not, to agree on
not
this.
Not like from inside my body, you know, like oh, stick them on a wire and it says, oh. Hello. It pops through my belly.
Kaliwa, kaliwa. Yeah, kaliwa, kaliwa.
What the fuck? What the fuck? Yeah. Don't do that.
Not like
not inside my body. Yeah, not stigmata style.
It has to be on a paper.
What about me?
Yeah, would you want, what do you want me Bobby to do?
I don't want you to appear anywhere.
You know what? I'll do a fart.
I get scared
easy. I'll do one of my farts. My ghost
yes,
farts.
Yes, yes. No, no, no. Not your ghost farts, because when he sleeps, his fart sounds like popcorn.
Yeah,
yeah.
That's what you'll hear.
Like it's very, it starts slow and then it goes really fast.
Do you know why it comes out that way, by the way? What? Because I think that you think that I have a too tight of a butthole.
Mm-hmm. I don't think that at all.
No.
I have never thought that.
Because I don't want to fart in front of you.
Yeah.
I clinch my butthole really tight.
Naturally, yeah.
But the fart wins. Like the fart always wins, right?
It beats your butthole.
So yeah, I'm like, it's winning, right? Yeah, and then you go, pop, 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 you know what I mean? It's my butthole losing is what you're hearing. Yeah, that's what you're hearing.
Oh my god!
I don't have a tight butthole.
You're hearing defeat.
Yeah, that's yeah. You're hearing like my, cry. Yeah, my butthole going. Oh, I give up. You win.
So you would hear Bobby's fart.
You would hear my popcorn farts.
Makes perfect sense. Makes perfect.
Yeah.
Oh man.
Yeah, that's all I want to hear from you. Actually, I don't want to see your ghoulish face either. You as a ghost is terrifying.
Oh yeah, because I think I would like be such a. I would be the worst ghost.
In what way?
I think I would just want to fuck with people, you know? So I would do it like in the worst kind of ways, you know?
He would make it spread on me.
Yeah.
Just like, he would you're, force, you're sleeping and your butt cheeks just open?
Yeah. Oh, yeah. I would be one, definitely a rapist.
Yeah,
a ghost rapist.
Like Hollow Man.
Yeah.
Oh,
you know, I would like go into like high schools, you know, and go to the female locker room and just hang out on a locker.
Just in a locker.
Is that weird? Is that pedophile?
Yes.
No, it's a high school of everyone over 18, though.
that
kind of high school.
Oh, that kind of high school.
Everyone's over 18. Yeah.
Everyone's over 18. Forget I said that. I don't know why I just said that.
Pop, pop, pop. Just go it's to my that. Butthole yeah. loose.
But do you guys ever think about that, though, the afterlife or no?
I do. I'm afraid that I'm going to die. Like you said, the whole black thing. You just made me like think about that. Like, am I just going to go into this black abyss?
Be a tennis ball?
Yeah. I just don't want to be. I don't want to know anything that's happening. Like I don't want to know that I'm in an abyss. I just want to end.
You don't want to have your consciousness. No. I'm okay with it just ending too.
No, but it's like nothingness is the scariest thing, because for 45 years I've built this connection with other humans and my place in the world and all the information. I just feel like it's a loss.
I think, you know what I believe in, though, to a degree, not fully, is some type of, like, reincarnation. And I have so many instances in my life where I've either heard something, smelled something, and I swear to you, it doesn't relate to anything that's happened in my life. And I'll give you a perfect example. There's a song called, by Alan Parsons Project.
I love them.
Yeah. There's a song by them, and it's, when I hear it as an adult, it makes me feel so strange. And I ask my mom and I've asked my dad, have you ever played this song around me? Have you ever, do you even know this song? My mom's like, I've never heard that song. It's called Eye in the Sky. I've never heard that song in my life. It's a pretty popular song now.
I love that song.
But my whole life, I've felt an odd, strange feeling every time I've listened to it for no reason at all. And I swear to you that it happened in my like my past life or something.
Mm.
And I don't know how to explain it other than I have a deep nostalgia for something that never was.
Mm-hmm.
You get emotional?
I get extremely emotional and it like tugs me, but I don't know why. And I've asked everybody in my life, like, do you know this song? And they're like, you know, it's never, you know. I was hiking the other day and I was like, crying when I was listening to it. I don't know why.
Really? You start crying? Wow. Over?
Yeah. And it's just that song.
Yeah. It's funny because before I met you, I loved that song. And you and I, and then when I played it, I think once.
Yes, and I cried in the car because he played it on his playlist.
But it's weird that I love that song and that because I've never dated anybody that even knew who Alan Parsons was. So when I could have been one of those things that Khalyla and I bonded over.
In a previous life, you think?
I think I've known you in a previous life for sure.
Yeah.
Whoa. Yeah, because there's an uncomfortability. You just make me so fucking angry sometimes, though. I mean, it's just like, it's like, what?
I've been obsessed with 90 Day Fiancé, so I've watched like all seasons.
Yeah.
And I'm telling you guys, I want to marry a Mormon boy. Ugh. It's official. And he's so angry that this is my final decision in life.
The fucking dumbest thing I've ever. First of all, number one.
What is that show? I don't know.
It's garbage.
Don't watch it.
It is basically garbage TV, but I'll tell you a quick premise is that people fall in love with somebody from a different country, whether it be because they met in that different country or they found them online, and then that person comes to the United States and they have 90 days to figure out if they're going to get married or not. So they get a green card.
99% of it is somebody that wants to become an American citizen.
Green card.
There's always that.
It's okay. Like the one that we saw. I mean, I glimpsed it last night when you were watching it. That older white Midwestern lady. With
Muhammad
two kids.
And Danielle. And that's a green card.
The guy is, how old is he? 22.
He's 26, and he's like a handsome guy from Tunisia.
How old is she?
She's a 43-year-old like fat lady who's cross-eyed.
Hey, fat lady.
Green card.
Hey, fat lady.
Green card.
Nobody wants to fuck you.
She has six kids, so yes.
Yeah, but no. At one point, yeah. But at 44 with fucking six kids, it's over. Kind of. Well, you're not going to get a fucking 26-year-old Tunisian guy who's good looking.
Maybe.
No, what?
That seems like green card.
That
Filipino.
Because after they got married, after he got his green card, he split. So obviously that's it. But there are stories there that are so heartwarming. And all of them involve Mormons. And that's why I want to marry him. They're so sincere and
you can't drink Coke.
I'm okay with that. That love that I see in them is so pure.
Oh, really?
They're so pure.
All right.
I'm seriously converted. I think I love Mormon boys.
I want you to become Mormon.
I might be.
I want you to go to Utah. All right. Meet some white dude who's a Mormon. I'm telling you right now, in 3 weeks you'll call me, "Puppy, I want to come home. Pop up. I go, "Nope.
I got excommunicated."
Yeah. Cuz as soon as you stick your finger in their butthole, that's your move.
Yeah.
They're going to be like, whoa, you know, they're not going to like that.
What are you doing?
What are you doing? You know? Yeah. That's where poop comes out.
Mm.
Yeah.
Yeah, you're not going to like it.
I don't think they have rules about sex, though. They only have rules about having sex before marriage, but like what they do during sex.
Also, Prop 8, was that the marriage proposition?
The gay one? Prop 8. Might have been, yeah.
Yeah. They were... That the Mormons were the ones that like those anti-Prop 8 campaigns, they funded that.
Okay, I regret what I said then.
I mean, they have so many, you know, ideas about.
I just thought about, I have.
Stop
I
watching that fucking show. It's fucking you up.
90 Day Fiancé.
They make the Mormons look so good.
And what's up with the TLC in general? You don't learn shit.
Oh my God, they have other
shows. Their learning channel?
Called My 80-Pound Groin and A Man With No Penis.
Yeah.
Side by side on each other.
Whoa.
The only thing you learn from the Learning Channel is that there's freaks in the world.
It's all reality, right?
Yeah. Mm. 26 midgets, albino midgets living in a house.
On its fifth season.
In an island, you know, and you're like, what am I watching?
I forgot that's the Learning Channel.
Remember that half gook with the kids? What's his name?
Oh, John and Kate plus 8.
Yeah.
Oh, the Octomom, yeah.
Whatever happened to that?
That wasn't the Octomom.
It's not Octomom?
No, John and Kate plus 8 is different.
That same thing, right? What's that boomshakalaka girl? What's her name?
Boomshakalaka?
The little girl that's sassy.
Jazz. Which one? Oh, Honey Boo Boo.
Oh, I called her.
I was like, Boom Chakalaka. It's like an urban, like,
brother Boom Chakalaka. Boom Chakalaka. Yeah. Honey Boo Boo. That's TLC, right?
Mm-hmm.
Wow, TLC.
And that channel is killing it, right?
They're killing it.
Ratings, yeah.
Yeah, the ratings. Hoarders, is that
Hoarders
A&E?
Is that's TLC. A&E.
No, they were A&E at first.
But now it's on A&E's TLC, I think. Mm.
Yeah. I mean, you know. I like the one with the obsession ones.
Which ones? Oh, I eat toilet paper?
Yeah, or the people that pluck the hairs off the head.
Trichotillomania.
Yeah.
Mm. Yeah.
I have some.
I have trichotillomania.
So
in what way?
You do?
Yeah, I have. You know, you see me. I tweeze my shins.
But not on your head. You don't do it.
No. But I have them. I tweeze my shin hairs every day of my life.
Yeah.
Isn't that just grooming?
It feels painful, but so good. I can't stop.
Yeah, I mean,
isn't that grooming?
I think my thing is the fingers around my. I just eat the fuck out of my fingers.
Yeah,
around the side, and then I meet guys that have the same thing, and then I look at them, I go, oh my God, we're the same type of people. So my fingers, Sandy Danto has mm-hmm. these, right? My agent, Ben Day, mm-hmm. he doesn't even have nails.
Ow.
I mean, it's literally just nubs now. Oof. He's grinded it down so much.
But it's from anxiety, though.
Esther Pravinsky, David King.
Yeah.
He bites his nails, too.
It's anxiety.
It's anxiety?
Yes. That's one of the most like hallmark signs of anxiety is biting your cuticles and your nails.
Yeah. I don't think I can ever get rid of that. It's just something that my brother does it. It's just something mm-hmm. that we do.
Steve, but you guys do this weird thing where you guys are obsessed with bad smells, you and your brother.
I love it.
I hate it. You're always like, and doing that.
Oh, you know what I do?
Sniffing your fingers
you know
all day.
Do? You do that too?
I do it too, yeah.
You know what I do?
What?
I cup my farts.
I yeah. do it too, dog. Do? Yes.
I go pop, 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 and then I smell them. Do you smell it?
Yeah. I cup it to throw it to see what it's like.
Yeah, me too. I want to know what it's like. Because if it's like not smelly, I go, I'm healthy today. But if yeah. it's like deep, and you know, then
what
I'm like,
the fuck oh, did I
going,
eat?
Yeah, what's yeah. going on with my life?
You've never you cup, you like never that? Cupped your own fart.
You never cupped your own farts.
Well, one time I trapped it in like a Tic Tac box, and I had my sister.
Like it's a spirit.
How did, yeah. that's a tiny hole. What did? How did you do
how did
that?
You do that?
I put it in a Tic Tac box, and I told my sister, "I was like, hey, look, there's no candy, but it still smells minty." And
I put it in. That's a good one. I'm going to do that too.
And she basically ate my fart.
Yeah.
Oh,
but I was
God.
Like 10 years old. I don't do it as an adult.
Aww. I want to do it in a maybe in a, like a jar, jug or yeah. maybe to see what happens.
Oh, wow.
Can you fart in a jug like for a year and keep it in there?
Yeah, could you yeah. store the smell?
You just it would just have to be vacuum sealed. It had not vacuum sealed. I'm sorry. It would just have to be airtight.
Interesting.
Yeah, but how do you do that? Like, because if you release the plug to, you know, to stick your
yeah,
butthole
yeah,
in
yeah.
it, it would escape again, right?
So it had to just, it would have to be a one-way seal.
Yeah.
So it can't come out, like a valve, so it can't come back out the other way. It would have to be airtight just one direction.
Can somebody invent that? Any TigerBelly fans, can you invent a mechanism?
Send it to Bobby.
No, I'm being real.
So you could trademark your scent? Call it popcorn?
Popcorn?
No.
Bobby's popcorn.
No, popcorn.
Yeah, yeah.
Ah.
No, popcorn.
Like a little butt piece I can stick, you know, sits and then have, you know, a jar, mm-hmm. a jug where it only releases in one end and I can preserve my farts.
This is interesting, actually.
I want to see what that's like. Let me ask you this. Yeah. What have you eaten on your body?
Oh, God. Oh. I've smelled a lot of things, not eaten.
What have you eaten in your body?
Oof. I'm really, really obsessed with swallowing my own phlegm. Mm.
Yeah.
When I cough it out, I don't spit it out. I have to swallow the loogie. I like the taste.
Outwardly.
What do you mean?
Like, I don't go inward. I go outward. Like, I'll pick my nose and eat it.
Oh, oh shit. I go in.
Yeah,
you go
I go out.
Out.
I go out.
You let
yeah.
it enter the world.
Yeah.
You take it
yes,
back in the world.
Because I need it to breathe like air.
Like wine.
And yeah, like wine.
You don't want it to escape or be given to
no.
the
because
world.
The thing is that it's literally the same thing.
It's the same thing.
Yeah. So if I'm picking my nose and I eat it, don't judge me. Like,
yeah.
oh my God, he's 12.
Yeah. Mm.
Who does that?
Yeah.
Everyone does it.
Mm-hmm.
But I just do it in a more sophisticated way.
Mm.
How about scabs? Do you eat scabs?
No, never. I don't even pick them.
I've eaten scabs. Have you?
No.
Never.
What about clipping your toenails and smelling it?
I'd done that, for sure.
I've clipped my toenails and eaten them.
Ooh.
God. Oh, wow. Okay.
Yeah, yeah. Ooh. I've done stuff.
Toe jam is my least favorite smell, I think. That and C. diff. Two worst smells ever. What are the two smells you cannot stand?
I'm about to admit something right now that I never thought I would ever admit in my life. In fact, I might not admit it. Let me think it through.
Okay.
Yeah, I'm not going to admit it.
Mm.
Yeah,
come
I'm not
going to
admit it.
No,
I can't do it.
It's my birthday.
Oh.
I need this gift.
She wants a fun
this
fact for her
then.
Birthday.
No gift then for
Allah.
You.
No.
All right. I'll give you a
level check.
Khaliwag. Okay. All right. Here's what it is. Okay.
You don't want to do it.
I'm going to do it. So what I would do is I would take a razor blade,
mm-hmm.
not a razor blade, a shaver,
mm.
for, you know, your mustache, what do you call it? Just a
shaver, yeah.
Yeah,
shave.
A disposable one.
Yeah, single
and I
blade.
Would shave the bottom of my feet, the skin.
You have admitted this.
No, but I'm not admit this.
This
next second. That's just
okay,
the beginning.
Okay.
That's the beginning.
Right, and then what I would do is stick it, like I would take the shavings and stick it in a bowl by the bathtub
mm-hmm.
so it dries out.
Okay.
So then you would have feet shavings from my green foot.
Yeah.
in a ball, right? And I would put glue in it.
Mm.
And I'd roll it into a ball and see how big the ball could get.
Ew.
I know.
Whoa, that's elaborate.
Right.
Wow.
So you basically have like...
He has a drying process. You do that with food.
It's a meatball.
Yeah, yeah. And then so one day, Christine was living here.
You have told me this story.
She found a ball this big.
That big?
Yeah, I was for years. And if you smelled it, it was not... You would literally vomit.
Yeah.
And I've never admitted that before in my life.
You have. I've definitely heard that story.
What did Christine say when she found it?
I go, it's just a glue ball.
Was she just playing with it?
No. She picked it up and she
was
like,
what is this?
Yeah. No, it was heavy.
Jeez.
Yeah.
Oh, that's disgusting.
It was yellow. It looked like mucus, but it was solid.
Oh, wow.
Yeah.
Poor girl.
Guinness World Record.
Did you ever admit that to her, what it was?
No. I just admitted it now.
You can't say that.
I think I might have one.
I might write her and be like, hey, that ball was foot shavings.
What?
Yeah. You know what? It feels good to say things that you were going to take to your grave.
Yeah, let's do that right now.
I just did it.
Secrets we've never told.
I just did it with my foot.
Yeah, but you've told me that sort of
story. Yeah, but not on this podcast.
Gilbert, I need a secret
this
from
might
you.
Not be too
it's for
weird.
Her birthday.
It might not be too weird. I pick butt, like, I straight up, like, make a V with my legs. I just pick my butt hairs while I'm watching Netflix.
Wow.
Stop.
Only Netflix. Stop. It has to be not Hulu.
No,
fuck
no,
Hulu.
No.
Netflix.
Only Netflix.
That was the worst one I've ever heard.
No, it's not.
It's so weird.
You've never picked a butt hair.
Your legs flipping open like that, like you're doing like some sort of gymnast move, right? And you're plucking hairs out of your butt while you're watching something is fucking weird, dude. I can't believe you admitted that. You did.
Oh, fuck.
So, yeah. Baby, what about you?
Oh, God.
Something Bobby doesn't know.
No, this is something that I have to throw my girlfriends under the bus.
Go ahead.
Do it.
It's
your birthday.
So if you guys don't, men might not know this, but all women know, we have our own version of schmegma.
What's schmegma mean?
Schmegma is technically the term for when you're uncircumcised and the cheese that
sits
on the top of the...
Discharge?
Yeah.
But
actually in women, it actually hardens up a little bit and you could basically scrape it out with your nails.
Ooh.
Like when you wash, your daily washing. See, you guys think it's disgusting and it's normal for us, right?
Yeah, but what does it look like?
Yeah,
it looks like cottage cheese. Okay, I don't even want to tell the rest of my story.
It's to build
please,
the story.
Please, keep going there.
Go back to the cottage cheese.
Cottage cheese.
Yeah.
Well, one time when we were younger, my girlfriends and I were in Vegas and we were all showering together.
Oh, so not... Yeah, she was an adult, though, by the way.
Might have been.
Younger, it's not you're 12.
You're in your 20s. Yeah,
20s. You're in your 20s. Go
but
ahead.
We had a schmegma fight.
Oh, my God.
We were like scraping and then flicking at each other and then dodging.
Oh, my God.
Oh, my God.
Matrix shit.
Holy. That's like...
It's worse than throwing poo.
It's the worst.
Maybe.
But it's not unsanitary. It's coming out of my body.
I'm going to tell you something right now.
You eat my pussy, Bobby. What the fuck is the difference?
If I ate your pussy and there was something in my mouth
solids?
That tasted like fucking cottage cheese.
It doesn't taste like
that. We're
going to
have a very big problem.
Sweetie.
I know, right, George?
You
even
have eaten my schmegma for sure.
Texture for sure.
It's not disgusting. It's
right,
just discharge.
Is there vitamins in it?
Probably.
Then fine.
I want to see if there was like any kind of like nutrients in it. Then I would be like, okay, I'll eat some of that.
All women, 100% of women have this. So why is that disgusting?
Okay.
It's part of nature.
But is that the same as discharge?
No, discharge from an infection is different from just
regular, everyday. That I don't want. Oh, come on, George. Relax.
We don't have discharge.
Everything's fine.
Yeah. Sometimes we get feminine dijingis.
Yeah, I just, the vagina is...
A cavernous place.
It's a cavernous place. We don't have.
Why do you guys like it so much? Why do you guys like it so much? It is a very daunting area. It's beautiful in many ways because
yours is beautiful. I've seen some.
All are beautiful.
No, I've seen some fucking krakens out there. You know,
release the kraken.
Release the kraken. Like just with teeth.
Ooh,
and
ooh.
Like scales. Like what is that?
It's probably a twin if it has teeth.
The vagina is a very, like, it's, you know,
It's a wide range.
It's a wide range, yeah. But I prefer a specific type.
I love guys, though. What turns me on is when guys don't give a fuck. When you haven't showered, when they just want all of you, even at your worst.
Yeah.
That's so sexy. When guys like, fuck it, let me just eat you
cottage
out.
Cottage cheese and everything.
Yeah, schmagma. I love that. But when guys are like, no, can you shower first? I'm like, oh, come on, you're such a pussy.
Do I ever said that?
No, you always want me, however.
Yeah, yeah. I'm a warrior, that's why, guys.
Yeah. Even on my period, and I,
Yeah. And
this is a really disgusting podcast.
We talked about a lot of things, you know, but we're not done. I also want to say this to my Chicago friends. I'm rooting for the Cubs.
Yes, we are.
Oops, and the reason why
for this hat, I'm really
is adopted. Because I have so many friends like Ike Barinholtz, Chris Watowski, just a lot of people. You, a lot of people that are Chicagoans, and I was always the guy that like would rub it in people's faces.
When they lose.
Like if somebody was like a huge, like, you know, baseball nut or football nut, and if they lost the Super Bowl or whatnot, I would go, in your face, I like the other team, you know, and just to get a rise out of them. But that was before I, you know, knew about Arsenal. You know, I'm a huge Arsenal fan. And now that I love a team and I really care about the result, I feel sympathy.
Mm.
It's so funny how you can change over time. I used to hate sports. Anyone that I hate jocks. And I think a lot has to do with, like, I was picked on a lot by jocks. Just don't like the mentality, but I really enjoy watching soccer and especially Arsenal games. Mm. Like the other day, you know, it was tied 1-1. And
Sunderland?
I thought, yeah, against Sunderland. And I thought they were going to be, it'd be a draw. And then they put in Olivier Giroud. And his first two touches were goals.
Damn, son.
It was unbelievable. I remember it was like 6 in the morning. I was running around. Remember I was running around the living room screaming? Mm-hmm. I just really love that sensation and that feeling. And so I'm rooting for the Cubs. And I'm not rooting for the Cleveland Indians, mainly because John Caparillo is from there.
The main reason.
Is the main reason.
And also the RNC was there.
Doesn't matter. You know what I mean?
I'm rooting. Well, I always root for whatever team beats the Dodgers. So I want to see. It brings me comfort to know that the Cubs made it to the World. I need the Cubs to win. But most of all, I want the Cubs because they beat the Dodgers.
Mm, yeah.
I want the Cubs to win because I'm in love with a particular storyline between Anthony Rizzo, the first baseman, and their starting pitcher John Lester.
Mm-hmm.
They both like survived the similar type of cancer. But then when John Rizzo was 18 and he was basically still being like, he was still in the minors, I think, and he got diagnosed with cancer, he met John Lester, who was playing for the Red Sox at the time. And John Lester basically told him how to beat cancer. And then now they're on the same team together. How great is that?
It's pretty crazy.
That like touches my heart.
It's crazy.
Yeah. So I'm rooting for the Cubs.
Yeah. I don't understand baseball at all. But you know what? It's something interesting that by watching it the last couple of days, or just
with
glimpses
me, yeah.
with you, I can understand now why it might be fun to watch.
It's so fun. Ball games are the baseball games.
Especially
are the best.
when that's on the line. Like I can understand how like, you know, it's the ninth inning, a team is winning 4-0. And then all of a sudden, the bases are loaded.
Mm-hmm. Yeah,
you get a home run, and it's you know what sports is there's tension and pressure, like and then a score or anything like that relieves it, and then there's that feeling of, you know,
yeah.
I couldn't even find the word. I just put my hands up like this, you know, that feeling.
Yeah,
I can understand it. But it's still a pretty boring sport.
It's not boring.
Because there's a lot of stopping. There's a lot of like, you know,
it's
people
too
just,
long.
You,
it's
a
too
shot long. Of a guy chewing something.
That is true.
But,
right? And they're like, what is he chewing? And then like.
But that's the beauty of it. It's a place to take your whole family. You know, you sing in the seventh inning stretch. There's downtime. There's uptime. And I think that's why baseball games are so fun. It's more of a chill environment rather than 90 minutes of intense, like, you know, at the edge of your seat feeling. It's not like that. And I think that's, you know, they're great sports in different ways.
I mean, I like soccer because there's no commercials for 45 minutes.
Well,
oh, that's true. They just play all the way through.
It's great.
I like the feeling of being in Chavez Ravine and Dodger Stadium just chilling for 4 hours.
Yeah.
When someone gets a base hit, then, you know, everyone gets excited, and then we sit down again. We eat some more peanuts until the next one.
Yeah, but I don't like watching a sport like, oh, my God, are we going to score? And all of a sudden, Celino and Barnes, injury attorneys, 888-888-888. And then you're like, oh, fuck, that we're about to score or whatever.
Yeah.
I want it continued.
Yeah. Soccer's like that, yeah.
Soccer's, yeah, I know it is.
No, I know.
My flat-faced friend.
Thank you. Salawa.
And also, I just thought of something just now. That kid that was at that party, I mean, that podcast we did live. Remember that kid that said he would help me write?
Oh, your joke writer.
Last night, I saw him at the Comedy Store, and I looked at him, and I didn't say hi.
Because
I looked at him, I go, how do I know him? And I walked by, and I just thought of it just now.
Oh, my God, So if you're listening,
I'm sorry I dissed you last night.
He just forgot.
No, it's just you're at the store, and a lot of people just want to take photos and stuff like that. So you just kind of like put a wall up, you know?
He said he wanted to write for you.
I know, but here's the thing is, and I feel really gross about this, but you can't open your heart up to everybody. Mm-hmm. You know, you can't say hi, be nice to every single person, because then all of a sudden people use you. You need a little bit of a wall. You need a little bit of a thing. You know, I love TigerBelly fans whenever they ask for a photo. But there was a guy last night who brought his friend. His friend had never heard of me. And I just happened to have an okay set. So now he wants to take a photo. And it's like, nah.
I'm good.
Because you're just now, you know. Mm. No, I mean, I want to take photos with people that are genuinely, you know, people that like me. Mm. Would that sound gross to you?
No.
No, please tell me everything.
No, it makes sense.
Okay.
You're always very nice. You never say no to a photo. You are a yes man through and through.
Yeah.
And it irks me when you say yes in the middle of our meals.
Yeah.
So when we're chewing our food and then people are like, hey, can we get a picture? And then you smile and you have beets all over your teeth.
Yeah. You know? I can't say no.
Yeah. I can't say no.
And I just feel, God, I mean, it's just your birthday and stuff. And I just.
Do you care about Manny Pacquiao fighting
this
weekend?
No, I want to talk about your birthday for a second.
Oh, okay. Sorry.
I just.
So much pain.
I'm not good about any of that. Christmases and all that stuff. I wish I just didn't grow up with it. I feel bad about it.
I'm sorry. I'm in so much pain
right now. Sorry, baby. where are we at time-wise?
You guys always nail it now. It's an hour.
Fuck, I'm so
scared. I'll help.
No, not yet.
Okay.
I just want to say
more
this.
About my birthday, please.
Yeah, I want to talk about her birthday.
What are you getting me? Do you have any ideas?
Yeah, this is what I want to do.
Okay.
Is I want to just wake up tomorrow.
Yeah.
And we'll get a meal. And then I want to buy you like a $1,000 leather jacket.
Oh, I don't want that.
Yeah, but why can't that be it? Why does it have to be like something like...
Bobby, let's run a mile together.
Why can't I just like get you a nice jacket and then go happy birthday, baby, and then move on?
Because there's more to it than just material stuff.
I know.
But what was last year's gift?
Nothing. And that's okay because you know he spent the whole day with me.
Oh, that's what I meant. That's the
yeah. I'm gonna spend
so that's everything. That's
yeah, I'm gonna spend. Tomorrow, I'm gonna spend all day with you.
He wants to get me this super expensive leather jacket, and I just don't think it's.
All of a sudden, she's like, no, but what about the cows? And he's like, fuck it,
fuck the cows. Your birthday.
Do the fucking question.
Unhelpful advice with Bobby at Khalyla.
This is from my friend Mina. Hey guys, I have been married for a year and living with my husband for a year. We live 5 minutes away from his parents and my parents. We just got a new puppy. His parents are obsessed with our dog and come over to see her while we are at work. It has made me uncomfortable that we have guests over when we aren't home. I'm grateful for their help but don't want people in my home when I'm not there excessively. His sibling asked to bring over a friend so she can meet the dog when we aren't home. Am I being weird that I want my privacy or should I just let them help us with the dog as much as they want?
Thanks. This is the thing. Is... your in-laws and whatnot, you cannot make them your enemy. Like, for me, as long Khalyla's sister, Khalyla's mother, even Jessica, or close friends, can be in my house even if I'm not here, because you have to open your house up to her loved ones also, because she lives here. And I don't have a problem with that. If I'm on the road, or if I come home and I see some Jenna or Jessica and she's not in the house, I'd be like, fine. I'm okay with it. I really believe that because if you say, no, I don't want people in my house when I'm not there, it's going to cause resentment. It's going to cause your wife to have a resentment too. It's going to cause unnecessary fights. Who gives a shit? What's in your house?
It depends.
That's so important. Why?
That's not true. Because you and I, we're a little bit more lax about our house rules, revolving door policy. You know, my whole life I've had couch surfers live with me 3 months and I never hear from them again. So like, I'm cool with people in my space, but not everybody is like that. And you should honor that there are people who are a bit more private about their things. And she said that her family member brought a friend over. And if she's never met that friend, how is she to know that that friend
That's one thing, but he said the parents.
The parents is, but we can't impose what we believe in onto somebody who wants her more of her privacy.
I'm
going
to just say this, though. If you and I were living together and my mom wanted to take a nap here and you weren't here and you were like, no, I have to be there for my mom to take a nap there, it's over between us.
But you already know I'm not like that.
I understand that. I'm just saying that because to me, that's so fucking weird.
It is weird for me.
I think it's weird universally.
I will say that if you ever did the same to me and if you said, hey, can your sister not come over right now? Or I would feel resentment towards you.
I feel the same way.
But other people, let's say if Gilbert was like, hey, my friend John from,
No, Gilbert doesn't even get to come here.
But Gilbert has keys to our house because we trust him.
Yeah, he's fine. Let me say this. If you have keys in my house, if you fuck a girl in my house on my sheets without washing them like my brother did, we're going to have a very big problem.
Steve
did that. Mm.
So what's your final answer for Mina? What do you suggest? Just letting it go?
What?
Talk to the parents or just let it go.
Let it go. Let them stay at the house.
It is really good for your growing puppy to be as socialized as possible to as many people. That's actually to her advantage. But if it's someone that you don't know, you have the absolute right to be like, hey, I'm not comfortable with that.
Of course, strangers, but like not the parents of your wife.
Mm. Yeah. Your mom can nap here all day, every day. She can live with us. That would make me happy.
Yeah, I know. And your mom's the same way. And that's how it's been done through the fucking ages, my friends. Right?
Maybe it's cultural.
What color are they?
White-ish, maybe. Caucasian.
Mm. I find out that, you know, I don't want to call it a white thing, but...
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear Khalyla.
Shit, that scared the fuck out of me.
The way they did it, like I knew it was gonna happen.
Yeah, me too.
But the way they did it, I almost fucking died.
I got scared as fuck.
Is this the purge?
Holy
yeah, yeah. It's the purge. Yes, it's hey.
Hi, mama.
Can you tell the audience what happened? Just happened. Now?
Oh my God! So my sister Renzo, Jenna, and my mom just got here and scared the shit out of me. Yeah. Oh my goodness, you guys.
Yeah. Hi. Happy birthday.
Happy Halloween too.
Happy Halloween.
Thank you, guys.
Oh, it's great.
I'm sorry.
It's so great. Anyway, thanks for listening to another episode of TigerBelly. It's Khalyla's birthday, I'm going to send her gifts. Okay?
Oh, my goodness.
All of you, say hi to the camera. Say hi to the camera. You guys are all on camera. Right there. Point to that camera.
Thank you so much. Hi, Mom.
So, Mina, your question about your... while Khalyla's looking at her gifts, make sure you follow TigerBelly on Instagram at TheTigerBelly. Or on Instagram... at TigerBelly, sorry, and Twitter on TheTigerBelly. If you want to email any questions like Mina, you can send it to thetigerbelly@gmail.com. Also, our mailing box, George, is 161 North Wilcox. 1626 North Wilcox. Whatever. 161 is a suite. North Hollywood, California.
Costumes.
Whatever. Just fucking look it up. I just fucked the whole thing up. I'm terrified as fuck right now. I got scared the shit out of me.
I was so scared.
Thank you.
So send Khalyla some packages.
Don't send me anything, my God.
Okay, yeah. Don't send her anything. But send her leather jackets. $1,000 leather jackets.
The cows. No leather jackets.
But send her affliction jeans. She loves affliction jeans with lots of diamonds.
Please no. That's it.
All right, that's it, guys.
Thank you guys for listening.
Bye.
Bye. Ciao.
Say bye, everyone.
Bye. Kau dapat kembali.